In a recent video, I explained how to turn a daytime scene into a nighttime scene using Adobe Lightroom. A lot of people who saw the video asked how to do the same thing using Affinity Photo. So in this video, I'll show you the same thing, but focus on making the lights glow as if it's night. I'll start with the RAW file open in the Affinity Photo Develop Persona. I'll then use the exposure slider in the basic panel to darken the image by moving it to the left. What I'm trying to do is move the histogram so that it's compressed on the left side. Next, reduce the temperature slider to around 400 Kelvin to give the light a cool feel. I'll also reduce the tint slider to about minus 10 to prevent the image from having a pink tint. This gives a base image that now looks like it was shot at night. The only problem is that the lights aren't glowing, which is what we now need to fix. Unfortunately, this isn't quite as simple as it was in Lightroom and requires a two-step approach. The first part of this is to add an overlay to the light we want to make glow. To do this, I'll add a gradient overlay to the area in the Overlays tab. After clicking on the Overlay tool, I can set the type of gradient to elliptical. I can then position my mouse near to the neon sign and then click and drag to draw the overlay. Because I've picked the elliptical gradient, I can set the width and height separately using these two controls. After that, I'll click and drag the center line to change the feather on the gradient. When I have the gradient in position, I can go to the basic tab and increase the exposure. After you've done this, you may find that you want to reposition the gradient on the image. Next, I can increase the white balance and tint controls. This makes the area appear warmer than the surrounding image, as if light's falling onto it. That's the first step complete, but the effect doesn't look very convincing at the moment. To give the appearance of a strong light, we'll need to go to the photo persona next. But before we do that, I just need to click on the View tool at the top of the toolbar. This allows me to set the output options to produce a raw layer with the raw data embedded. Now I can click the Develop button and return to the photo persona for the next stage of editing. Here, I'm going to add a new brightness and contrast adjustment layer to the image. In the dialog, I'll increase the brightness to around 70% and the contrast to around 20. The adjustment's now affecting the entire image, but we don't want that. To fix it, we need to add an empty mask to hide the layer. If I click the mask icon at the bottom of the Layer Studio panel, I can choose to add an empty mask. This creates a mask filled with black, which hides the entire image. What I need to do next is click and drag the mask with my mouse, dropping it onto the brightness and contrast layer. It then hides the effect of only that layer in the image. I can now use a paintbrush tool to paint with white onto the mask where I want the light to appear. To paint, I'm using an opacity of 50%, a low flow setting of about 5%, and a hardness of 0%. This gives me a soft brush so that I can build up the light to make a convincing adjustment. But before I start painting, I'm just going to change the blend mode for the brightness and contrast layer to be hard light. This will create a more realistic effect in the areas where I paint the light. Now I can click on the mask in the Layer Studio panel to ensure that it's selected. Then, paint over the areas around the sign where I want the effect to appear. After painting in the effect, I can reselect the layer to adjust the settings. And I can also change the opacity of the layer to adjust the strength of the effect. The next adjustment is to add a white balance layer. I'll use this to set the white balance and tint slider to around 40% each. As before, this affects the entire image, so I'll add a new empty mask from the Layer Studio panel. I can then drag and drop it onto the white balance adjustment to hide that layer. Now I can click the mask layer to select it, and then use the brush tool again to paint in the effect around the neon sign. When the mask is complete, I can adjust the white balance settings further if I need to. Finally, I'll select both layers and add them to a new group. If I turn off the group, you can see the effect of the layers and how they're making the light glow. Now let's repeat the process, but this time making the light in the upstairs window glow. First, I'll take the image back into the Develop persona by double-clicking the raw layer. I can then click the Overlays tab where I'll add a new gradient overlay. I'll use this to draw another elliptical gradient, but on the light bulb in the window. I can then adjust the shape of the gradient and the feather so that it fits the window. Now in the basic panel, I can increase the exposure. followed by the temperature slider in the white balance section. All that I'm trying to do is make it appear that there's a faint glow around the light in the upstairs window. That will be enough to enhance with the other adjustments in the photo persona. Now I can click the Develop button. Back in the photo persona, I'll add a new Export Adjustment layer. Last time I used a brightness and contrast layer, but you can create the same effect with an exposure layer. I'll increase the exposure slider to make the light bright in the window. I'll also change the blend mode of the layer to hard light. Now I can click on the mask icon and add a new empty mask to the image. As before, I'll click and drag the mask with my mouse to drop it onto the exposure layer, hiding that layer. I can then paint over the window where I want to create a light effect. When that's complete, I'll add a new white balance layer so that I can warm the light. I just need to increase the white balance slider to around 60%, which gives the appearance of a yellow glowing light. Now I can add the empty mask to the image using the masking icon. Then click and drag the mask, dropping it onto the white balance adjustment layer. When that's in position, I can paint on the mask with white to reveal the adjustment in that area. Let's select both layers and group them. If I turn the group off and then on, you can see how it makes the light appear to glow. Now for a couple of tips to improve the effect. Double-click the raw layer to open it in the photo persona again. In the overlays panel, I can select the gradient overlays and use the opacity setting to refine the strength of the glow. We can also continue to adjust the color temperature of the overlay, as well as the saturation and exposure. This helps to create a more realistic effect, and the entire process is non-destructive. Whilst this is more complicated than my original Lightroom video, it provides more control. If you haven't seen my Lightroom video, it's worth watching that next to compare the process and the results. Thanks for watching today, and if you haven't done so already, don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you soon for another video.